So we saw from the previous example of John Calvin, another one of the signs. No humility, or a lack of humility in some areas. You know, what is the number one sin in Christianity? Pride. This is the opposite of pride. Humility. And we picture Jesus washing the feet of the other disciples and being baptized by John the Baptist, being humble even though he was the Son of God. He was teaching us humility. He said that the one who's going to be the head must be the servant to all. Does this teacher have this humility, the humility that Jesus taught? What? How can you tell us? Well, the way I think is lack of personal stories of sin. You know, we read the gospel, and the gospel is not shy about telling us the failings of the apostles or the disciples. And Paul admits freely to where when he sins. The Gospels are even so honest to tell us that Peter denied Jesus 3 times and all the disciples scattered. You know, does your teacher give you personal stories of their sins and confess to you? Just because they're a leader, that doesn't mean they shouldn't confess to you, right? And they also, in humility, admit to mystery. When they talk, often, a lot of times when you meet pastors, they talk as if, I'm 100% sure of this. This is 100%, you won't see me say that. I'm saying, this is my opinion. This is what I see from looking at the scripture. I admit when I don't know, I admit that there's a it's mysterious. First Peter 5:5. Likewise, you who are younger, be subject to the elders. Clothe yourselves, all of you, with humility toward one another, for God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. We all know this. But you need to look. Do they admit when they're wrong? Do you hear personal stories? Are they just talking about doctrine, or they're giving you personal examples and giving you a testimony of how they came about this, you know? Stories of how they depend on God, or how they failed in depending on God, right? Now, this next one, I don't know if I put it into the right words here. But I think everybody will know what I mean here. A pastor who was 100, you know, Jesus was 100% man, 100% divine. Well, if the preacher or the teacher, 100% spiritual, always focusing on the spiritual, you know, these kind of people are no earthly good. In this, they play God. They often talk God this, God that. It's in a reverence in the amount of times they say God. And a reverence in the earthly things. An example would be peace in the Middle East. Peace in the Middle East. If you're focused on the end times and you think, you know, that the Jews have to be in Palestine for the end times, you're so focused on this, you're no earthly good. You think the end times are coming, let's not even worry about the environment. somebody who, like, okay, personal story. Sometimes my daughter, I'm so engrossed in these Bible studies. Sometimes my kids are here, and I'm not all there. I'm still engrossed in this spiritual warfare I'm in, but neglecting my earthly life. I still got to have a job, pay the bills, you know. And you can see this in some preachers. It's hard to put into words this, but you'll see what I'm saying. Number five is the opposite. You know, 100% earthly or practical. You could say, these are more conservative, more liberal. Can you say that? 100% practical. It plays to agnostics. People who are not sure, who don't have a lot of faith. They love preachers like this. They give nothing but milk. You know, Paul talked about with doctrines, there's the easy doctrines, there's the milk, and then there's the meat, the hard doctrines. They give nothing but milk. I've heard a lot of these preachers. And a lot of these Bible studies I'm going to do, I'm going to show you some meat that they won't talk about, that they're scared to talk about. Some of these that I'm going to have to talk about in this study, they don't want to tell you the hard teachings.